Ooh, new drone smell. Look what I got.
Mine.
I have to make pictures. I think I've learned how to use this thing by now. Alrighty, today we're unboxing this and this and not that. I don't even know what that is. Okay, I figured it out. The thing's moving by itself. I thought I was moving it, but we're reviewing this. This is courtesy of USA Toys. It is the FPV 220 RTF Force 1 Racing Kit. I like this whole, I don't have to do anything. Watch, I just sit right here. And this basically does the commercial for me. See? Look at that. Going too slow though. Move again. Move. 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 See? I got it. Right, so this is what they sent me. It was very nice of them to send me a complete kit for the FPV 220 RTF, which means ready to fly. You get the transmitter, you get the goggles, you get that little aircraft, and you get all these little decals you can put on your wall. Okay, no, you don't get any decals, I'm sorry. Maybe sooner or later they'll send decals. Let's open the box already, right? I know, what are you waiting for? The company that sent me the drone was also nice enough to send me a couple extra batteries. These are the tattoo batteries, that was nice of them. These are very nice batteries, 1300 milliamps. And it is 45C, 3-cell, 11 volts, 14.4 watts, in case you needed to put a light bulb on it. Finally, let's open the box. See what's inside this puppy. Whoa, look at that. Very nice presentation right off the bat. If I didn't say this, this is a sponsored video, but I don't have to go googly-eyed over this stuff because it's nice. They give you a little charger. And they also had sent me something separately to plug into the charger, some wires so I can connect batteries to it. I don't have that with me right now, but who cares? Look at this. Let's see what's inside there. So you can see this is very well packaged. Here's the drone. It's all buttoned down in there with a little strap. This makes a very nice traveling companion. And so let's take it out. Oops. We'll look at all that stuff in a second, but here's the drone. Here's my hand, here's the drone. This is a 220, has a nice camera all set up with a nice angle, has a mount right here for a camera like a GoPro or a run cam or a, you know, a session. You'll probably get that on there pretty well. Battery goes down here, nice spot for it. The motors are Force 1. I know, put the glasses on, I know. 2205s, 2300 kV, race edition Force 1 motors. They're really nice looking motors. I don't know, you know, if nice looking matters. But, you know, nice looking usually means well built. It looks like it's well built. So this is chamfered, FPV, Tampa FPV told me. Which, I don't know, sounds like wine to me, but it's chamfer, which means you won't cut your hands on it. Look, I can do this all day and I'm not cutting anything. Ooh, that hurt. From what I hear, these frames are pretty fast, pretty durable, and they're rugged. So, you know, I could do this all day with it and it's not going to break. I probably slam it on my head for a couple times and it won't break. This is harder than anything you've ever seen. Believe it. All right, Tampa FPV is making me be scientific. He gave me this caliper. So you put this on here like this, like that, and then you push it up, and it tells you how thick it is. You know how thick this is? It's thick. What do you need to know the exact number for? It's thick. This says thick on it. Look. Okay, there you go. Here's the antenna. Looks like it is right-hand polarized because it's got an R on it. Or you could think it's Robin from Batman and Robin. I'm not sure. Probably right-handed, not Robin. Sorry. We're gonna open up this side now. See what's in there. What are the goodies they gave us? So they give you some nice propellers. And then they give you some blue propellers. Wow, this is really nice. They give you some really nice tools in here. I don't know if you can see that, but it's a screwdriver, but it's a really one of those nice ones. I don't want to open it yet. Till later. Then we got some wires and more tools and some nuts. If you wanted to put red nuts on there, you've got it. What else is in the box? Look at this nice AT9 transmitter. We'll look at that and turn it on in a second because I know it has a color screen and you know how much we like color. All right, what else was in the box? They gave you the plug, transformer type plug for your charger, the IMAX B6. Man, this is just getting better and better, isn't it? Then they gave you these goggles. Can't beat that. And then we got the manual. And they give you this little plate. I think that's to protect your battery. What else? Did I miss anything? I think I got it all. So let's check on the manual. And let's see some particulars on this. Now remember, all the links will be down below. If you want to buy this from Amazon, it's an Amazon link. It is running a flight controller. Of course it is. Here's a very nice diagram of everything that's in there. There, now I don't have to explain it. Here's a very nice picture of the flight controller. There, now I don't have to explain that either. Here's a really another drawing that just shows dimensions. And if you stare at it long enough, you might go into the fourth dimension. Or fifth dimension. That was a band. Let the sun shine in. Ha! The flight controller is an SP Racing F3, and you can check and upgrade the firmware in clean flight. I'd be interested to see if it takes beta flight. We'll find that out later. We'll just stick with clean flight for right now. The ESCs are BL Heli S, and they are 20 amps. Those are pretty good ESCs. The video transmitter is a 25-200. The covers and angles, the camera angle covers 30 to 40 degrees. The camera is just rated as a CCD 5-volt camera, which I think was probably about a 600 TBL. No less than a 600 TBL. And if I can find it in here, I'll let you know what it actually is. Time to look at the transmitter. Get that out of here. Damn styrofoam always haunting me. Oh, hey, what's this? Oh, comes with a little receiver in there. This is an AT9 Link R9DS receiver. I don't know where that is with the spectrum of transmitters, but it's Radio Link. It's a good transmitter. Probably one of the better ones out there. As I understand it, this will be the first one I ever had. So, what you'll have to do is open up the inside. Here's the whole board. This is an all-in-one board. And the connector for the receiver is this one with the three colors on it. It's a servo cord. And you'll plug that in, and you'll plug this in, and then you can put the cap back on like this, and boom, you're done. Ah, I'll get it. So looking at the transmitter, you can go 4-cell batteries, or you can take a nice life battery and plug it in there. It's very hard to see the markings, but the plus or positive is on this side, negative is on the other side when you plug it in. So we got that plugged in, and look how nice that screen is. Color. It's color. Fancy. We're gonna put this all together. We're gonna take it out flying on Saturday, and we'll take it down to the beach and get some nice scenery. I'm gonna launch it just as it is. I'm not putting it in clean flight to adjust anything. The most I'm gonna do is balance it, and that's about it, because you, as the person that would be buying it, may not know how to do these things. It's RTF, it's supposed to be ready to go. We're gonna find out how ready it is to go. That said, Mighty Thor from somewhere in this fake scuba shop, posing as a drone factory, but making it look like a thingamajob, babob. I don't know, somewhere in the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida. See ya.